It's got to be one of the favourites. It's very simple, very quick. Start to finish, 10 minutes. Crispy bacon, parmesan, eggs, cream.
Cream and the carbonara. Actually, Marco Pierwhite is one of my favorite chefs, but Crimine Carbonara is not good at all, guys. No. He's not Italian. I will show you how we do carbonara in Italy. So we are just outside the central market. We're gonna go to buy some amazing food here at the local market where the best ingredients are in Florence. Ciao!
Ciao! Ciao ciao!
So we're just inside the central market and let's go to buy some guanciale. Come with me.
Allora, mi servirebbe un pezzetto di guanciale per fare la carbonara.
Sì. Ah, porchetta! Roasted pork!
Fry! Pulacino, sì. Così,
che
va bene?
Sì.
Allora,
ah, bello sto.
Taste now for you, eh?
Amazing.
I think for you to taste.
Amazing guanciale for good carbonara, man.
Exactly.
Assaggiare un salamino di cinghiale come Dio manda.
Ok.
Cinghialino.
Qui let me try whiteboard salame. He said it's amazing, let's try.
Good price for you, eh, madam. Where are you from?
Grazie.
Prego.
Hong Kong.
Taste.
Oh,
thank you.
Piace? Mm-hmm. Questo è il formaggio della domenica.
Madam,
yes.
Taste.
Okay.
Classico fiorino tosca.
Yeah.
They're gonna make me fat. Yes or no?
Yeah,
esatto. Buono, yeah. buono.
Thank
you. 8,50 euro.
Bye-bye.
Grazie.
To make carbonara sauce, guys, we need 3 egg yolk, about 30 grams of Parmesan cheese, and then the guanciale, pepper, and salt. This is gonna be enough for 2.
So we're gonna add in our eggs the Parmesan. We're gonna mix a little bit. You don't have to go crazy. You just mix a little bit. We're gonna add some pepper in it. So it's really important in this recipe, the pepper, because this recipe actually is coming from cacio e pepe. And then we add a little bit of salt, okay? So then you mix like this. You're looking for something like thick, okay? Start to getting thicker because of the Parmesan, right? Reach this point, okay, the meat is start to getting brown, is caramelized, we're going to take out the meat, okay, we can put our meat in a bowl, our guanciale in a bowl like this, okay, we leave all the fat, that we don't gonna throw the fat, okay, we're gonna keep the fat because in the fat there is all the flavor, and we're gonna use to cook our pasta, okay, so for the moment you take out your meat and you put on a side in the bowl. So today, guys, we're gonna use spaghetti, that is the most classic shape for carbonara, and we're gonna use about 150-160 grams of pasta for 2 persons. And then we're gonna add some salt in the boiling water, okay? Because pasta have to be salty. All the salt is coming from the pasta water. Then you take your spaghetti like this, without breaking half, and you drop the spaghetti inside, okay? Perfect. So to make sure and the pasta is ready, you can take out one, okay, and you taste it. Have to be hard a little bit, okay, because you wanna finish the pasta in the sauce. Okay, so the pasta is ready, guys, we're gonna take with the tongs like that, we're gonna drain our pasta in the sauce, and then we're gonna switch on this the pan, and we're gonna start to cook the pasta into the sauce. Okay, it's important if it's too dry. Okay, you take one ladle of water and you add one ladle of pasta water inside. Okay, you always use the pasta water because there is starch inside. This one is important to make the sauce creamy. Okay, so it's really important to use pasta water. And now we're gonna finish to cook the pasta in the pan with the fat of the guanciale. We're gonna add half of the guanciale inside, okay, and half we keep for like garnish on top. Okay, if the pasta like now is not ready, you can, like we say, take the pasta water and you add some of the pasta water and you keep cooking the pasta into the sauce, okay, until the pasta of course is cooked. Yeah. Chop the pan, the sauce is reduced, and we wait at least 30 seconds before to add our eggs, okay, because if you add the eggs straight away, the pan is gonna be too hot and you're gonna make like scrambled eggs, okay, but we don't want this one, we want to make the eggs creamy. It's the time to add our eggs, okay, so it's the most important step of the recipe. You take a little bit of eggs and you add first a little bit of eggs like this, okay, and you start moving, okay, so the eggs and the parmesan, they're gonna be cooked by the pasta, okay, you see how much is coming creamy, and you don't have to see all, the eggs doesn't have to be cooked, okay, so have to be just cooked enough to get creamy, so you add a little bit more, and now you turn the pasta, okay. If you see that like now is a little bit too thick, you take a bit of water and you add just few drops of water inside, okay, to make the right consistency. You see, I have to be a nice yellow creamy, yeah? So we're gonna take the pasta like that on the thon, and when it's on the thon, we're gonna put the top of the thon in the ladle, we start turning, we put our thon into the bowl, we press a little bit with the ladle, and then it's gonna stick like this, okay? Beautiful. So we have little bit of our guanciale and the crispy guanciale that we leave before. And then we're gonna take some parmesan, and we're gonna add some parmesan on top. So this one is the best carbonara. Let's try how it is. So have to be creamy like that with the crispy guanciale on top, and this is make the difference on the texture. So good. So guys, like the video and subscribe my channel, and I wait you here in Pasta Class Florence. In Pasta Class Florence. Pasta Class Florence. Flowing thing.